next to the floating living river, next to the corner Lovelock Bridge, next to where the salmon spawn, and next to apparently the best stairs to run up.
It's nearly 5 o'clock, and we can still see the sunlight. This makes me really happy.
Only time will show.
Do you understand what I mean?
I wouldn't like anyone to pressure me from the top, but I'm no worm also.
I think this is so important to understand seasonality and natural changes, and to feel even more grateful for our changes. I am obviously thinking about time and how to handle all this in such a compressed way.
And we are placed here in the end of February with bright sundays and freezing temperatures. But my heart is where the trees have crooked completely because of the west wind.
These little holes are so perfect and cute.
And on all the skins, there are eggs.
The sun is shining so warm these days, and while walking around, I can see all the small baby buds on all the plants ready to sprout.
Should we just make it a ritual to do one cooking session every week? So, once again I dreamt about the worms. I dreamt that they had eaten everything, and that they were popping out of their home. We found them all pressed together, and also on the floor. At one point I was proud of their progression, and that they liked our food. On the other hand, I was sad that they were overpopulated. Maybe one day we will start liking the scent they are living in, that I assume they must like.
I imagine how cold it must be for any kind of worm under the soil if they are suddenly covered with so much heavy snow.
Let's try to slow down a bit and give them time.
They try to tell with bad smell and mold, but we misunderstood. I am sorry.
Let's slow down a bit and give them time. Warm, friendly food.
It was zucchini and parsley, and I had it on room temperature for around 48 hours. Soft Savoy kale. It seems as if everyone is trying to harvest the sun these days.